Romans, the fifth chapter, the third through the fifth verse, say, and not only so, but we glory. We glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and the patience experience, and experience hope, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Your tribulations are a condition, but it is not your final position. Ephesians, the third chapter, the 13th through the 14th verse, declares, wherefore I desire that we faint not at my tribulations for you, which is your glory. For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. 2 Timothy, the first chapter, and the fourth verse declares, so that we ourselves glory in you and the churches of God for your patience and faith in all of your persecutions and tribulations that ye endure, which is a manifest token of the righteous judgment of God, that ye may be counted worthy of the kingdom of God for which ye also suffer. Your suffering and tribulations are a condition, but it is not your final position. And when you get sick and tired of being sick and tired of those same Negroes that keep coming against you, I have some good news for you. I have something for you that will put all of those troublesome people in check, and it will give you some peace. 2 Timothy, the first chapter, the 6th through the 9th verse. Seeing it is a righteous thing that God come, thing with God to recompose tribulation for them that trouble you. And to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus Christ shall be revealed from heaven, and his mighty angels in flaming fire taking vengeance on them that know not God, and they that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. I'm almost done. Just before I take my seat, I want to share with you about a man. Don't go there, Michael. Who was in a condition, but he knew it was not his final position. This man went through every kind of trial that you can possibly imagine. He took the bombs of life to show you that you can take the small bullets of life. That man is Jesus Christ. I know some of you in here are now saying in your mind that I don't understand.